There are all kinds of divisions in our world, but the great division is the division that exists between those who by grace are members of God's family and those who remain outside of God's family. There is no social benefit now to being a Christian in North America. And why is that? Because there is a prevailing hostility against the teaching of the Bible and therefore against those who will affirm the teaching of the Bible. And better than that, who will actually live it out. We're living in a culture that has actually dismissed biblical Christianity. Marriage, understood throughout time as between one man and one woman, to affirm that now is to be regarded as bigoted. When the Christian affirms the fact that society can only be strong and happy where the marriage bond is held in honor, instead of people standing up and saying, wow, that is so wonderful, it helps our nation. No, it's regarded as a threat to the well-being of a culture that has actually decided that the self, the you, the me, the thinking, feeling, doing part of me is actually at the center of the moral universe. Young people are growing up being told how you think and how you feel and what you desire is the key to your entire existence, and you're able to make sense of yourself in that way. We must abstain from selfish, indulgent, natural appetites which feed our egos and destroy our souls. Either we are operating from a worldview that is framed by the thought forms of the age or by a worldview that is grounded in the will of God. No possibility of compromise, actually, between the two. They're incompatible. You're to abstain on the one hand, and you're to become an advert on the other hand. An advert for what? An advert for Jesus. Keep your conduct honorable, not engaging in the cultural warfare using the tools that the world offers us, rhetorical tools and weapons that destroy and demean and are cruel. Who am I supposed to be honorable about and to and with? Everyone. You see, when you think about homosexuality per se, forget transgenderism for the moment. But homosexual people are either hated or they are affirmed. Those are the only two options. Either you hate me or you affirm me. The Christian actually does neither. We do not hate, but nor do we affirm. We cannot hate because of God's word, and we cannot affirm because of God's word. And we have to be prepared to say that we are unprepared to rewrite the Bible in order to accommodate a society that needs the Bible and that needs the Jesus who is the focus of the Bible.